Hey everyone, and welcome to my October and November 2017 collective haul. In this haul, I'm just going to be showing you some things I got from October and November this year, as well as some things, you know, like outside of the months a little bit, just including them in, but it's mainly from October and November. Okay, what am I showing you first? So first, I'm going to show you this scrapbook. I got this from Wilkinson's, that's right, if I remember correctly. I was just in Wilkinson's buying some new folders and things like that for more organisation. And then I came across this beautiful scrapbook. I believe it was about £5, I might be wrong, I'm not too sure. I can't remember the price that well. But yes, when I saw it, I just thought it was so beautiful. And I really love how these has leaves on it. And then how it has these golden leaves in particular. And then as you can see, it's sort of shimmering in the light. Just thought it was really pretty. And I wanted a scrapbook for a while now, just to do some designs and drawing for like makeup ideas and stock ideas, because I create stock for DeviantArt. So I want to get a bit more creative with my stock a little bit. And like from before, I've like drawn it out, drawn the makeup out and drawn the clothes that I'm wearing. But it wasn't in a specific book, so I thought I should, well, I thought when I saw the scrapbook it would be good for that. So I could just develop my ideas more in here, keep them together. But yeah, I just made a little title page as well. That's a promos concept development. So yeah, so just to have all of my ideas and designs in one place. Help me really, so it's not scattered everywhere, it's actually just easy for me to find and design in one place. Yeah, so that's just what I did so far with it. There's nothing done, nothing yet in here yet, actually. Empty pages. I also like how it has the gold, I can't remember what it's called, it's terrible. The next item I'm going to show you is this folder that I got from Home Bargains. I just thought it was so cute. Just get all these unicorns all over it, and rainbows, and sunshine, and clouds, and stars. And I just thought it was too cute not to buy. It's pretty shiny as well, I must say. See the window in it? And it's pink inside! Yeah, and it's just, I don't know if you can see that properly what I'm doing. It's one of those kind of folders. Just clips. And then you also have this thing. It's just a terrible demonstration. A little sticker as well. Pretty magical, it says. And I can't remember how much that one costed, so sorry about that. Okay, next I'm going to show you the things I got from my trip to the V&A Museum, including this bag. They had a choice of different tote bags by the till as I was paying for my items, which I'll show you inside. And it had like green, red, blue, and I think yellow or something. Maybe it's orange. And I chose the blue one. And inside, we have this souvenir book I bought, about £5 or something. And it just has different images from the collection. Also, I bought this postcard. And I also got this pencil. It just says V&A. If it would focus, it would be lovely. But it just says V&A. On the other side, which I really liked, it says, dream, study, and I can't even read that from here. Admire. Things I got from Primark. So I got this, if before October, I'm not gonna lie. But they're still there now. I saw them when I went back the other day. So, just, I'm not even too sure what this is. Oh, it's gift wrap. I was gonna say it was paper, but yeah, it's gift wrap. Gift wrapped. Gift. It's gift wrapped. It sounds weird. Gift wrap. There we go. Gift wrap. Okay, I think I've got it. But, yeah, I wanted to get this more for like backgrounds. So, as you can see, it's like, yeah, I think I could fit in like a portrait shot. Probably, maybe. Again, for like my stock that I make, and also for my YouTube channel when I do makeup tutorials, kind of a nice gold background. Maybe I'd have to put two strips, so one here and then one next to it. Looking normal now. And it could cover a bigger space. And yeah, that'd be really pretty. It's, the colour of this is copper and it's £1.50. I also got another one in this lovely pink colour. And it says, oh, it just says it's pink. And it's, this one was £2. Yeah, again, for the same purpose. It's like a metallic sort of pink, I would say. Next item from Primark I'm going to show you is this travel pillow. Now, I actually got this for my mum. It was meant to be for her birthday present. But then, surprise, surprise, being a Disney fan herself, she got one for herself. So now this is mine. Yeah, I'm happy with it. I thought it was nice enough for myself. When I buy gifts for people, I try to make sure it's something I would like, or something of, how do I say it? Something they would like that I would like too. So not some rubbish. You give to people what you would like to receive for yourself. What's the moral of this message? Or message story, the moral of this story. Anyways. Yeah, and as you know, I go to Disney, or I've been to Disney a few times now, and so in future, if I'm going, I could definitely wear this travel pillow, or if I'm just going anywhere else, it doesn't have to be Disney necessarily, but it'd be nice to bring Minnie along with me in any way that I can. Let's actually put it on. Ooh. Ah! It's my first travel pillow. It's actually pretty comfortable, I think. Imagine going to sleep. Those are different head positions. How would I sleep? Probably like this or like this. It's quite comfortable. Just if you lean back. I think it works quite well. Mess up my hair now. Yes, I'm very happy with it. Very, I think it's very cute. And next I'm going to show you this nightgown. It's not a nightgown, but it's nighty. It's Game of Thrones! Woohoo! I don't even know if you can see where it is, can't see a thing. But yay! Excited about this one. I was in the store with my sister, and I recently started watching Game of Thrones. I'm on season 4, so please don't ruin it for me. Write some spoiler and comment or something. I just won't even look at these comments if there's any comments, but I won't even look because I don't want it spoiled. But yeah, so I started watching the show and I really enjoy it. And one of the houses, one of the families houses. It's called surname. Ugh. Their surname is Tyrell, and that's my surname. I'm Valencia Tyrell. So it's just really cool watching the show. And when they go, Tyrell, Tyrell, I'm like, ah, it's me, all the time. And the girl, I really like the girl in particular. I can't remember her name. I'm not like that great a fan, but I do love the show, and I can't remember her name. Anyways, but yeah, she's the Tyrell girl, and I really like her. So far, because I haven't seen up to season 7, so I don't know, she might turn evil or something. Well, I don't think she will. But yeah, so yeah, it's really exciting just having a name included in the show. Especially because they spell it the same way we spell it. T-Y-R-E-L-L. So, because normally people seem to be familiar with it with a double R. Or whenever we see it, whenever like any of us are watching telly and there's credits and someone's got a Tyrell surname, there's two R's, there's never just one. and people always pronounce our name. Oh, they call him Tyrell. I can't remember how they say it, but we pronounce it Tyrell. But it's just nice to have it spelt the same way that we spell it, and yeah, it's just cool. It's a really cool football. So anyways, yes, here's the nicey. But yeah, so I got one for my sister as well when I was there. I was like, oh my gosh, I have to get two. It was for me and my sister. I really like the black and gold as well. I think it's beautiful. And show you the bottom. Come on. Yeah. It's got gold little gold trims to the ends. Also on the sleeve as well. And across the neck. Yeah, I'm really happy with this. And here's the tag as well with the Iron Throne. And this was £7 and it's in a size 6 to 8. Oh, and also inside here it has the Game of Thrones logo again and HBO. Oh, my thing's falling down. The last primer item I'm going to show you is these Harry Potter cards. It's mainly because my sister loves Harry Potter and I would love to give her a Harry Potter card. So then when I saw this pack of cards, I just thought, oh, let's get it so I can give her a Harry Potter card. I should open it actually. Have a look at the different ones inside. So I just broke my thumbnail when trying to open deck of cards, so I'm just fighting. Oh, gosh, I'm really impatient. There are four different types of cards. We have this one, and inside says Happy Christmas. And then we have, oh wow, oh that's pretty, I'm seeing it for the first time, because it was hidden, like, oh you saw, not explaining it for, this is Hogwarts inside of a bubble, or it is like a trophy, like a Hogwarts kind of trophy, yeah, very pretty. This one's been folded weirdly. Get it? But it's very pretty. Can we fix this? This is Hedwig, isn't it? If I'm right, I hope I got his name right. No, it's she. It's a she, I remember that. I hope I got her name right. Hedwig. I think it's focused now. So yeah, we have Hedwig flying through the moon. With a broom! Oh, it's beautiful. I love this one. Very nice. What does it say? Sent by Owl Post. That's cute. And then the last one is the one you can see from the back. It's this one with the, is it Magora's map? Madora's map? Map? Yeah, I'm terrible. I need to read the books and watch the films. I say that like every time. Medora's map. I think it's Medora's map. But I might be wrong. And it says Happy Christmas. Really kind of like the house colours. Because this one's yellow for Hufflepuff. This one is blue, so Ravenclaw. This one is red, so a Gryffindor. And then this one is a kind of, it's green, is it green? I'll say it's green, Slytherin. It's different green from this, but it's kind of green. It looks bluish a bit, but I think it's just about green. Green enough. Green enough. And then just the envelopes. So now I've got to decide which one I'm going to give to my sister and my friends. Oh my gosh, what's wrong with me? On the back it says, pack includes four designs, and it shows the pictures of them and everything. So I wasn't concentrating then. I think that's it for the Primark. So, what's next? Next I'm going to move on to Superdrug. Okay, so First, I'm going to show you this mascara by Barry M. And it says feature length, or it's supposed to give your eyelashes a feature length look. And what else does it say? Specially designed brush to lengthen and define lashes, black mascara. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, but I got this just because it was pretty. Literally, just because of the, is this rose gold? You guys know, should know by now that I'm like rose gold all the time. But I just, yeah, I like the color and the design of these. They look like black scales, like on a mermaid. Or black outlined. I don't know about black, but scales on a mermaid kind of look. And I've used it for my makeup now. I'm showing my eye. It's a bit blurry. So yeah, and I think it works really well. Here's the spoon. You can see it properly, I don't even know. Is it more focused on my hand than an actual spoonie? But yeah, I think it's very good. Definitely made my eyelashes instantly look longer, and it kind of, I feel like it stretches them out, especially the bottom lashes, because when I used my mascara before, I don't think it gets as long as it is now, but maybe that's just me. Yeah, I really think this is pretty pure color, and it works well, very good. And also I like how they're like spikes, I don't know if that's what it's called, but I'm just gonna call it that. They're kind of like they're separated from one another, they're not all clustered together, and it's nice and thin, so it's just easy to use. But yeah, I feel like it's easy to just comb your lashes. And I also got another Barry M product, which I'm wearing again now in this video. This Matte Me Up Lip Kit Metallic Liquid Lip Paint and Lip Liner. So it's a like a little pack, a little kit. It's got two products inside. If I can get them out. So it's got this lip paint, so it says. I call it lip gloss, but it's a lip paint. Do it all swatch now. You can see it on my lips now, but that's how it's on my skin, and I can do it on this spot too. Swapped it off before it dries. And also there is this lip liner as well. I guess mine's kind of blunt because I just used it, but yeah. Buying two in a pack together ensures that they're the same shade. So your lip liner completely matches your lipstick, or lip paint I should say, which is much more convenient. And go on, drop tip. The colour is Avant-Garde, so it's like a dark purple colour. So yeah, it dries really well I think as well. Let me do a little test. Barely any bit came off just now. Oh, good old girl. What is next? Do my ears look weird like that? I just felt like doing that. It just feels kind of comfortable. I don't know. I just have one side. I don't know if I should do both. Do I look funny? I don't know. It is. Ooh. Okay. Oh, last item from Superdrugs. Is this Barry M again? And I got this nail paint. They call their names fancy names, nail varnish, but it is nail paint. It's true. and it's a limited edition colour. I felt like this matched the lip paint I got, and also it's just really pretty. It's purple, and it's like, it looks like blue inside, but it's like a metallic sort of purple, I guess. And it's not focused, so you can't see it properly. But yeah, what colour is this again? It says Purple Hex on the tag. Shake well, keep from heat, apply base coat before use. Oh, I'm not very good, then I don't use base coats. God, I thought using base coat wasn't it. Anyways, let me show you what it looks like on without a base coat. Don't follow me though, it says to use a base coat. If you can even see properly. I'm probably going to wipe this off after as well because I can't be bothered to make it to dry. So here it is. Oh, it looks kind of rubbish like that. I'd need to have another coat to show it properly. But just to give you an idea what it looks like. Oh gosh, it's a terrible demonstration of what it looks like on the actual name. So next I'm going to move on to H&M. No, actually, I think next I'm going to move into some items I got from a charity shop. First I'm going to show you this. I just thought that every girl should be able to buy herself a rose, and then with this one, because it's made from fabric, it won't decay or anything, so I just get to keep it forever. Like, I thought, let's just buy this. It's like a reminder that, you know, you don't need to have a boyfriend or anything to have cute things like this, really. It's important for, I feel it's important for women to value themselves and love themselves without needing a boyfriend to validate you or a man to validate you. So that's why I bought this for myself, really, just to symbolise that. Plus, I think it's cute. And we have these bears. I don't know, it's a popular brand. I can't remember the brand. Best Friends or something like that. I have other items my family members have bought for me. These bears on it before. Yeah, it was really cute. It's this lovely, lovely red rose and red heart as well. And the leaves, and then we have the stem. We have some ribbon just to decorate going around. The first thing I bought myself is... Me again with this. Game of Thrones Season 1, the DVD. Okay, so the seasons... right now, I can't find anywhere to rent them or to stream them or anything. And my sister hadn't seen it yet, and I really wanted her to see some of it, just to see how she felt about it, if she liked it. So, yeah, so when I saw this in the charity shop, I thought, ooh, I should just get it, and it was £4. So when I checked online now, it's around, I think it's £10 if you want it new, and like £6 if you want it used or something, like Amazon. So yeah, I was really pleased when I checked and saw that the price was much more than I paid, and it's in very good condition. And yeah, so I'm gonna... So we have our character here, it's called Ned Stark on the Iron Throne. And we have the back here for some of the main cast. This cover is very beautiful. It's got these patterns all along here and the sides as well. And then the actual just a case, so inside we have the actual DVD case. The same thing on it, it's very shiny, very reflective. And then on the side there's a little book. Oh, I don't know if it's a book, it's like a spread out, which tells you all the different episodes and shows you a little map of the houses. And I won't show you for too long because I don't want it to get ruined for anyone that hasn't seen it yet. and then we have the discs inside. So we've got on each disc two episodes, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And we have watched all the way up to, we're on the last discs now, so we're just about to finish the season, and my sister's really enjoying it at the moment. So I'm glad that I bought this. And also it's got bonus features on it, so the making of Game of Thrones, creating the show opening, from the book to screen, audio commentaries, and I like study film and pursuing film industry career, so with the bonus features as well, I had to buy it. Yeah, it just said something in there. Oh, it's an episode guide. Oh, I need to read more. I'm very pleased with this. And then, oh yeah, and also, I do know that like there's other seasons and things, like why just buy the first one? But I guess I'm okay to own this one because it's like a special, I don't know, it's just really pretty, whatever. And it's the first season, and then when the last season comes out, if I like it, that is, then hopefully I can just buy the box set. So I'll have the box set of all of them up to season, I think it's season 8, and then I have this to go with it as well. Okay, next is clothes I bought. So I bought this skirt. It's very thick, very warm for the winter time. And it has this button here. That's why I didn't undo the button. And then this is it as well. And this is originally from New Look. Oh, it's got another button in here actually. We button that one first, and then we button this one at the front second. Yeah, I thought this would look nice with a pair of black tights and a black jumper. Maybe one that I bought, I showed you in my Primark haul. We also have pockets. Two relatively big pockets as well. Yeah, so it's originally from New Look. And it says that on the tag, BSB Jeans, established 1980. And the dress, got the straps, and we have this, I don't know what to call it, like cups for the chest or whatever. And the little lace section in the middle, and then we have the skirt section of the dress as well. And then we have the back, just the zip. I thought this was very, very pretty and more edgy kind of look, kind of like a warrior. I've already done a warrior makeup tutorial, but it just reminds me of warrior, so I don't know what I'm gonna do about that. Can't do another one. Maybe I could do another one, I don't know. Could do another one, a theme, a different kind of themed warrior look or something. But yeah, I really liked it. It looks so pretty. Is this skull covered dress, originally from H&M. This was mainly because I wanted, if I Halloween. Because the time was like Halloween season, I thought, ooh, I dressed for Halloween. Maybe if we get like a tutorial next year, I could wear it as the outfit. Just got these buttons. I don't even know what this is, metal kind of buttons I guess, but it's just the same as the front, the back, and it's originally divided at the feet. Next item from the charity shop is this skirt. So it's like underneath there's a skirt, how do I explain it? There's just a short skirt inside and then lace that's longer than the actual skirt inside, going all the way down to the bottom. I just think it's all so beautiful. It's so nice. Really nice, really like this one. And then the way the lace is, the fabric, it kind of, how do I explain it? It's not just one length, it's sort of, here comes down, like, I don't know how to explain it. Well, you can see for yourself what I'm talking about, right? I hope so. Yeah, I thought it was beautiful. It gives it a really flowy, flowy look. And it says Love 21, so I'm not sure again if that's the name of the store. Well, it's the original store. Here's the tag. And then the last item from the charity shop is this Jane Norman dress. I'm really, like, really, really happy with this dress. It's simple, but I just think it's beautifully designed. It's got these pink flowers on it. And then the back has this cutout section at the top and this string tie up. This Super Jogs, they're giving away these things for your bag when you buy from them, and I got this one. I don't know what it's called, tassel maybe or something. It's got a little star on it as well. But yeah, it's a metallic green sort of colour. So that was nice. I think it's nice for them to, nice promotion to do the store. Okay, next I'm going to move on to. I'm just going to show you what should I do next. H&M. So I just got two items from H&M. I got this basic T-shirt. Nice grey charcoal kind of colour, and it's increased grey charcoal colour, just basic regular scoop neck. This is more for, because it's getting pretty cold now, springtime really. I guess I could wear it maybe, it's still kind of autumn, so maybe with a, nah, it's too cold. Got this skirt, which I think will go nicely with that top. Yeah, it's a jean skirt, bottom it's like an A-line skirt, if I'm correct. I believe it's an A-line sort of skirt, with these buttons going all the way down. I just really like the look of this. And it was in the sale, so it's... It was originally £17.99 and I got it for £7. Exercise, trying to encourage myself to exercise, which I still haven't been doing. Maybe this might help. I got myself some trainers from Peacocks. I don't know if this is going to be enough motivation for the shorts that I got myself early on in the year. Ooh, dusty. It's dusty. It's been sitting on the floor gathering dust. Shows you what I'm like when it comes to exercise. Anyways, it was £10 and it's in a size 5. Yeah, I thought they were really cute. The main thing about them is that I think they're very comfortable. When I put them on, it was kind of like wearing bed slippers. And then as well, I love the design of it. Like, as it's just, you can see for yourself. I don't know if you like it, but I like it. But yeah, we have this, this kind of looks like lace a little bit. And then we have these, this is a suede sections here and here as well with the laces, and then obviously it's pink inside. I like pink, so that's a bonus. And then it's got a very thick sole, very thick bottom, and it's very squidgy as well. Squidgy's very soft and they're kind of like pencils. And then the back is pretty itself, even though you can't see it because I'll be walking on the floor. But yeah, I really like these trainers. They're very pretty and good motivation for me to exercise, hopefully. Looking for boots for a while now because, as you all know, winter is approaching here in the UK. And then I found this lovely pair in New Look, and I've already been wearing it, and I must say I'm very pleased with it. So I really love this, how it's got this crisscrossing design going on here. I think that's just really cool. And then how we have the two buckles here for the design element. These are heavy, so I'm gonna put one down. And then how the front of it kind of has a point to it, but it's not too pointed, because some of the boots I tried were very pointed and it was too much, not enough room. So I felt that it wasn't enough room for my feet to fit, so it was just getting squashed. And then some of them I felt were too wide, so I didn't like that look either. So this one was just perfect. And I also like the bottom, how it's not just one flat surface, it's got some, I don't even know what to call it, a kind of grip to it or something. Maybe it doesn't make more grip, maybe it does, I don't even know. And it's got a heel, a little heel as well, not too high, I don't want to be in pain all day, but it's just enough. It's good, very good enough, very good amount. And then the back just has this thing. I guess you hold it quiet or something. Yeah, I'm very happy with these boots. I'm back to Game of Thrones again. This kind of reminds me of the Iron Chair, the way, Iron Throne, how it has these crisscrosses. I don't know, maybe it's just me, but it kind of reminds me of it a little bit. They're very warm, very comfortable, and very stylish. Come to the last item. And this is not something I bought for myself, this is something my sister bought for herself. And then she found that the site, and I'll just show it to you. It is from Killstar. And you probably can see it properly, you see it's shiny. It's reflecting the light. So yeah, it's from Killstar. And it's this beautiful skirt. Beautiful skirt. Black skirt with all these white moons on it, crescent moons, and it's a lace or something. Yeah. If you have a kind of elastic, oh okay. Got is it three layers or is it two? Well, it's just two. So it's like an elastic kind of skirt, and then we've got a lace going over the top. My sister bought this skirt for herself in a size small. What she found is very, even though it's an elasticy skirt, this bit on the top isn't elastic, so it's a like a snug fit. And she felt that it was just a little bit too tight for her, so she ordered herself the medium. And instead of returning this, she gifted it to me. So that's very kind of her, I think. It's beautiful. It's actually my first Killstar item, and I'm very happy with it. Killstar is like a luxury or expensive brand, you know. So I haven't bought from there before. I would like to buy more clothes from there, but you know, in the future, not now, not now. But yeah, so it's nice to have a Killstar item, and they said it's my first one. It's a beautiful skirt. And even their tags are so pretty as well. The labels, I can say, this is not a tag, is it? No, it's a label. The zipper is at the side. Yeah, thank you to my sister for this. It's beautiful. Oh, it is luxury. It doesn't look really bad, it's not me making it up. But it says occult luxury. And so that is it for my October and November 2017 collective haul. Thank you for watching again, and I hope, as I always say, if you like any of the items, you can find them in store. And yeah, just thank you for watching, and I will see you in my next video.